Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can use if statements in C++. Let's get into it. If statements are pretty sweet because it's like a basic form of decision making. We can specify some condition, and then if our condition that we specify is true, we can have our program do something. If that condition is not true, we can skip that or have our program do something else. So in C++, this is what you do to create an if statement. You just type in if, then you need a set of parentheses, and then a set of curly brackets. So anything within the parentheses will be our condition. It's like the rule. We're going to do whatever is within the subset of code between these two curly brackets if this condition that we specify is true. So there's many different things we can use as a condition, but I think we'll just start with something simple. Let's say that we want to check to see if somebody's age is equal to 18. First, let's create a variable. We can say int age equals 18. And then within the parentheses of the if statement, we can check to see if age is equal to 18. Honestly, we can really do anything with if statements. We can check just about anything. But let's check to see if age is equal to 18. Now, if you're checking to see if one value is equal to another, you don't just use a single equal sign. That is the assignment operator. So if you were to say age equals 18, well, C++ thinks you're attempting to assign the value of 18 to the variable age. So if you want to compare if two values are equal, you need to use two equal signs. And this is also known as the equals to comparison operator. So basically, if our age is equal to 18, we're going to do whatever is within the subset of code. Let's place a cout statement within these two curly brackets so we can just verify that the if statement actually worked. So we'll say cout, then use the insertion operator, then let's display a message. Congrats, you are 18 years old. I'll just say YO for years old. Yo. All right, so let's try this out. And our result is, congrats, you are 18 years old. So what if we changed age to a different number, like 17? Well, let's see what happens when we try this. So it doesn't appear to do anything, and this is the reason why. Within our if statement, within the condition of the if statement, we're checking to see if age is equal to 18. Since our age does not equal 18, it's 17, this is going to evaluate as false, and it's going to skip over anything within your subset of code. There's other comparison operators that you should also be aware of too. So this is the equals to comparison operator. It compares to see if two values are equal. If you use an exclamation point, then an equal sign, this is the not equals comparison operator. This will check to see if two values are not equal. If both of these values are not equal, then this entire condition will be true then. So if we check to see if age does not equal 18, it will execute whatever is within our if statement. So a more appropriate cout message would be something such as, you are not 18 years old. So let's try this out and see if a message displays this time. Yeah, and it says, you are not 18 years old. And if we were to go back and change our variable age to 18 and then rerun this program, well, we don't get any result this time because we're checking to see if our age does not equal 18. Currently, it does equal 18. So this entire condition will become or evaluate as false. So then, if this is false, we will skip whatever is within the subset of code for this if statement, and we continue on like it never even happened. There's other comparison operators too. These you'll probably be a little more familiar with. We can say things such as greater than or less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. So I'm thinking what we'll do for this, we'll change our if statement to say if our age is greater than or equal to 18, we'll display a different message. Congrats, you are an adult. So we can basically change our age to anything, our age variable that is. Let's say that we are 90 years old and we're going to check to see if our age is greater than or equal to 18. and it says, "Congrats, you are an adult. Well, you know, we're 90 years old, so we've been an adult for a long time. But yeah, you can check to see if, like, numbers are within a certain range, too, and stuff. And if we were to say our age is, like, perhaps 12, you know, then run this. Well, it's going to skip over this if statement because our age is less than 18. It's not greater than or equal to 18. Let's move on to phase two of if statements. So there's this thing called an else statement. If our condition turns out to be false, normally we'll just skip over whatever is within the subset of code for the if statement. We can use an else statement if we want our program to do something else. So after your if statement, just type in ELSE for else, and then it has its own block of code then. So basically, our if statement is going to check to see if somebody is greater than or equal to 18 years old. If it is, or if that's true, we will do this. If not, we will do something else. So let's display a different message. Let's make a cout statement that says, you are not an adult. Okay, let's test this theory. So our age is currently 12, so it says you are not an adult. And remember before when we didn't have this else statement, it just skipped over the if statement completely. But if you have an else statement, it's going to instead do whatever is within the code block of the else statement. So it's like you're at a fork in the road and your program is going to decide which path it's going to take. So I'll give you a visual example of this. So here's a visual if this helps you understand it. I actually copied this from a few other lessons on the same topic that I made in other programming languages, so don't tell anybody. But basically, it works just the same. So we have our variable age, and when we reach our if statement, if our age is greater than or equal to 18, we're going to go down this path and do something else with our program. If our if statement is false, we are going to use this else statement, and our program is going to take this path and display a different message. So this is like a visual representation, if that helps you. So with that being said, I'd like to introduce a variation of the same program, or something similar to it. Now with this if statement, this condition will evaluate or return an answer of being true or false. So what if you had a Boolean variable? We could create a Boolean variable such as adult. Boolean adult equals, and we can assign this a value of true, or perhaps false. And then instead of having a condition such as age is greater than or equal to 18, you could just put the Boolean variable name within here, and it's kind of like the same thing. It's going to check to see if this evaluates as true or false. If adult evaluates to be true, then we will display congrats, you are an adult. If adult evaluates as false, then we will do whatever is within this else statement. And since our Boolean variable is set to false, it displays you are not an adult. But then if we were to set this to true, then it's going to perform whatever is within the if statement then, where it says, congrats, you are an adult. So that's an alternative way to write something within an if statement, because basically it's going to return a result of being true or false. And if you were just to stick a Boolean variable in here, you can check to see if this variable contains the value of true or false. Let's move on to phase three on this topic of if statements, and we're going to cover the else if statement. So I think this is best if we were to create an entirely new program. So what I think we'll do is that we will prompt the user to enter in a temperature. And if the temperature falls within a certain range, we will display a certain message depending on what the user typed in for a temperature. So to begin, let's create a variable, perhaps an int, called temperature. And we can just declare this. We don't need to necessarily assign a value right away. And let's create a prompt to ask for a temperature. And we will say, please enter the temperature. Perhaps we'll put this in Celsius. Then we need to place a cin statement after this. We will say temperature. All right, so this will prompt for a temperature, and depending on what the value of temperature is, we will display a particular message. So let's write an if statement. If, I'm just gonna copy temperature because it's not that fun to type this out. if temperature is greater than, perhaps, 30 degrees Celsius, we will display a message. So we'll say, see out, it is hot outside. Maybe I'll add an emoji here. It's not required, but I think it's silly. It's a dude sweating. All right, so if our temperature is greater than 30, we will display a message. It is hot outside. So what if we want to check something else too before actually using an else statement? Well, we can use an else if statement. It's kind of like if our if statement turns out to be false, we can check one more thing or a few more things before we result to the else statement. So let me give you an example. Let's check to see if our temperature is less than zero. So I think that's the freezing point in Celsius. Let's display a message that says, see out, it is cold outside. Then let's add an else statement. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to change this to greater than or equal to 30 and less than or equal to 0. All right, so let's add an else statement. So basically, if our temperature is not greater than 30, greater than or equal to 30, and our temperature is not less than or equal to 0, it's going to fall within a certain range of 1 to 29 degrees Celsius. So anything that falls within that range, we could say it is perhaps warm outside. It is warm outside. Okay, let's test out this program. Okay, please enter the temperature. It is 50 degrees Celsius outside. It is hot outside. Let's try a different answer. Please enter the temperature. Perhaps negative 20 degrees Celsius. It is cold outside. Now, if our temperature falls within a certain range, that's basically how we set this up, it's going to just rely on the else statement because it's checking one if statement after another. First, it checks to see if our temperature is greater than or equal to 30. And if it's false, we're going to use the else if statement, and it's going to check to see if our temperature is less than or equal to 0. If that's also false, then we resort to the else statement, and that's kind of like a last resort. So if it's not hot outside and it's not cold outside, then it must be warm outside. So let's try this one last time just to verify if that's true. So please enter the temperature, perhaps 25 degrees Celsius. It is warm outside. Well, that's the fundamentals of if statements. It's a basic form of decision making. We can check to see if some condition that we specify is true, then we can have our program do something. If it's false, we can have our program do nothing or something else entirely. I'll include copies of the programs that we made in this video, and I'll post it as a comment down below and pin it to the top. But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started using if statements in C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.